Is he around the base? It's the base.
Yeah, control ward goes in. There's the flash from Khan. He just wants to kill the Evelynn before she can get there, but Thorn has teleported forward and powered recalls are going to be available, but Griffin, can they actually make the win? Oh my God!
Former coach CV Max has been accused of player abuse.
Tarzan has barely
it's a one-way trip.
He has the flash and he doesn't get it! As Tarzan gets so much back from the kingship, oh man, shockwave!
There could potentially be criminal charges involved.
The hype never ends when it comes to Griffin. Right now, they are at their hottest, at their peak.
The edge online for that fourth item. Oh, there's the flash Q! And Faker once again just annihilated.
Griffin using a fraudulent contract to trick Kanavi.
Clutch from Tarzan, but Morgana can't find it either. Viper stays alive. That's the full pentakill.
Your org is imploding in a black hole of drama, infighting, and national legal investigations. Well, that's exactly what's happening to Griffin.
Griffin actually hasn't been around very long. They formed in 2017 and stayed under most people's radars for most of that year. But in 2018, Griffin surprised everyone by tearing through Challengers Korea with a 14-game straight win streak. They added Chovy shortly after to complete the roster, but by then, they were already fan favorites. Their victories paved the way for Griffin to play in the LCK promotion tournament, where they once again proved that the young team was a force to be reckoned with.
With a tether, Nexus is exposed, Viper jumping to the side, finds the final kill, gets another one, the devil comes in, is beyond respawns, but it's just to see the Nexus crumble, and Griffin have done it, the 3-1 victory comes through. They delay MVP's hopes of making it back into the LCK, but they themselves have qualified for the summer split.
And even once they got to the LCK, playing at the highest level of League of Legends turned out to be kind of a breeze for Griffin. Griffin dominated the competition, ending the regular season in second above teams like SK Telecom T1 and Kingzone Dragon X. For anyone still on the fence about Griffin, the summer split was proof that they had to be taken seriously. And although Griffin fell in the summer finals to KT Rolster, most people chalked it up to inexperience. No matter how you looked at it, going from challengers to second place in the playoffs makes for a pretty good first split.
Spare a thought for Griffin, who have had a wonderful year. They were able to rampage through Challenger and came oh so close to making it both to Worlds and winning LCK. They will not be able to make it any further. They have so much to build upon.
And after an off-season win at the Kespa Cup, Griffin kept the momentum going in 2019 as well.
Gonna have to use that ultimate, does have that one available as the Voidseeker lands onto Sangun. Misses the ultimate from Tarzan as in goes the hands. Gets the quickness as Viper right into the backline. Key's gonna be taken out, but Sangun was the first to go down. Stopwatches are not gonna be able to stop this onslaught as Lava is picked off. We're looking for the pentakill. That's it for Viper!
Pentakill for Viper. Doesn't need an awesome dude, does it anyway? Frontlining on Kai'Sa and Griffin win the game.
But after another dominant season, Griffin fell short once again in the finals, this time to a revitalized SKT.
Spring often does this to us, gentlemen. We often get the quick ones in the early stages of the year, but this is one that I don't think anyone expected. SKT 3-0 over Griffin after their incredible first round robin.
In the summer, Griffin dominated the regular season, but the playoffs were all deja vu. They lost to SKT again. But with back-to-back first place finishes in the regular season and second place finishes in the playoffs, Griffin were guaranteed a spot at Worlds.
Griffin. The story of Griffin up until this point has been the young dominance that they have, individual stellar players.
CV Max, Griffin's coach since the very beginning, was often credited as the reason behind their incredible success. His focus on macro, strategy, and teamwork is what helped this team of talented rookies become a cohesive unit.
저희도 그냥 시간만 지나면 저절로 노련해지고 저절로 숙련된다고 생각하지 않아요. 좀 더 다 베테랑이 돼야겠죠 이제.
So when the news dropped that CV Max was leaving Griffin just 2 weeks before Worlds, the league community was stunned.
I'm not saying he's the best coach in the world, but I'm saying he's an extremely heavy-handed coach, and how Griffin got to the point they got, like, we can call it the best second place team in Korea ever. Like, they got there,
sure.
And CV Max played a huge role in it. Like, maybe it's his fault. they could never get pushed up all the way into first, but he was a huge part of like that team getting there from like they were what, 7th in Challenger, like almost getting relegated from like Korean Challenger to even below that.
But the community had no idea that CV Max leaving was just the beginning.
I'm just so excited to see Griffin finally make the international stage.
Crazy, but Griffin have found it in the end. Another ultimate in the one team fight from Lehens. And the last Q secures it for Griffin and puts them 2-1 at the end of their round robin.
So in a post-game interview at Worlds, which again was after CV Max left the team, Viper and Sword asked that CV Max stop lying about Griffin in his personal streams and just let the players focus on their gameplay. CV Max seemed blindsided by their comments. On his stream, he was even still rocking the Griffin jersey to show his support for his former team. But after seeing that interview, CV Max fired back and started revealing things that he alleged that he kept private because he felt they were too embarrassing. CV Max said he didn't leave Griffin voluntarily. Instead, he was fired by the team's director, Cho Gyu-nam. CV Max then alleged that Cho blamed him for the team's underperforming in the spring split, and then, allegedly, said that CV Max had nothing to do with Griffin's success. It was all just luck. CV Max also accused Cho of nepotism, particularly when it came to Sword, a player that CV Max alleged didn't measure up to the rest of the team.
CV Max said, "I don't think we can win Worlds with Sword. It's going to be really important that we get Doran ready when we go to Worlds because Doran is going to be our difference maker. We need Doran to be good. We need Doran to be ready." So CV Max believed he couldn't win Worlds with Sword.
And one of the craziest things is that while this whole mess was happening, Griffin was still playing at Worlds. And they made it out of their group in first place.
Jankos tries to disengage, but it's not a supreme display of talent. It is just a call for retreat. G2 running for the hills, and this is it. I cannot believe it. Domination from start to finish in two games straight. And Griffin make a commanding statement here.
They made it all the way to the quarterfinals, where they may have lost, but they did pull off one of the most incredible plays of the tournament.
When will they find it? What's the play? Forward they go. They might have knocked him down. Puts down the pool, but is there enough damage? They're going to try. They ult over the top, and it's already a 2-0. Viper doesn't die, but one finally comes through. It's up to Jackie Love, but he gets stunned. Clutch from Tarzan, but Morgana can't find it either. Viper stays alive. That's the full pentakill when they needed it most.
All right, so a warning for the folks at home. This is where things get extremely messy. There are a lot of allegations here, and some of them don't have firm evidence backing them up. So we're gonna do our best to try to keep things straight here. And also, I'm gonna say allegedly, a lot. The real shitstorm began when CV Max alleged that Cho strong-armed Kanavi, a minor trainee signed to Griffin, into signing a contract that was unfavorable and exploitative. The first weird clause in the contract is that if a player is sick or injured and has to be hospitalized for 30 days or more, they can be fired by Griffin for no other reason and with no warning. And crazier, if they're fired for that reason, they're not allowed to join another team for 12 months. The contract also states that a player can be fired at any time with no warning if their play is found to be lacking. If the team can't get in contact with the player, that is of course another reason to be fired, on top of a fine, and their salary will be taken away. And of course, it also states that if the player uses the Griffin IP after they leave the team in any way to make money, Griffin gets to claim all of the profits. See, it turns out that Kanavi's parents, who had to sign his contracts for him because, again, he was a minor, were allegedly tricked into signing a contract by being told that it just had some minor updates to certain clauses. Instead, the contract allegedly included a clause that allowed Griffin to transfer Kanavi to any team they wanted to without securing his or his parents' consent, which it seems like is what happened because Kanavi was sent off to play for JD Gaming in China. Kanavi's situation attracted the attention of Riot Korea, KESPA, and some Korean senators. One of them, Senator Ha Tae-kyung, warned Griffin and their management company, Still8, that anyone who coerced Kanavi, again, a minor, into signing any kind of contract, especially one that was exploitative, could be in serious legal hot water. Griffin was fined the equivalent of $85,000 because, according to Riot, people at Griffin knew about the situation and either helped Cho do what he did or just ignored it and let it happen. Riot also demanded that Still8 completely change Griffin's management. Even after he resigned, Cho was not gonna stay quiet, and he put his own accusations forward. Cho alleged that CV Max verbally and physically abused Griffin's players, saying that he called them names, choked a player, and allegedly said he was going to kill Sword.
During the investigation, we were notified of former Griffin head coach Kim CVMax Daho had taken violent measures physically and verbally during his tenure in Griffin. As of this report, we investigated further based on both parties related along with the statement of the witnesses and were able to identify that there was violence towards some of the players, and he got banned indefinitely.
Riot Korea, apparently having found evidence of wrongdoing from both Cho and CVMax in this situation, banned both parties from all future Riot events. But that wasn't the end. Senator Ha pulled no punches, saying that Riot could be punished for banning CVMax under a Korean law that protects whistleblowers, since CVMax was the one who made Cho's conduct towards Kanavi public in the first place. As for the contract that Kanavi signed, well, the senator declared it fraudulent and accused Griffin of forging legal documents. Griffin wanted players on unfair contracts because it meant they could loan them out to other teams whenever they wanted and collect sweet, sweet transfer dollars. But Kanavi wasn't the only one with a bone to pick. Sword in particular wanted to get his word in too. Griffin's top laner filed a police report, accusing CVMax of death threats and physical abuse. CVMax denies that he ever laid a hand on anyone, but he also maintains that the players consented to a more strict, harsh style of coaching, something that's allegedly pretty common in Korea.
But I just want to highlight the cultural difference between Korea and the West, right? In the West, if someone physically beat a player, my God, that person's probably getting fired and never working in esports again. In Korea, it's probably the norm, and most coaches have been doing that and have done that in the past.
Bowing under the pressure from Senator Ha, Riot eventually suspended CVMax's ban and has put him under a third-party reinvestigation. In the meanwhile, though, CVMax is already back in the world of Pro League of Legends, coaching Dragon X.
We, of course, do have the mad scientist, as he was dubbed by Papa Smithy when Griffin made their debut, of CVMax coaching these guys, going to be going through the draft. So if anybody is going to have some questionable picks that can come through, it's definitely going to be him with the squad.
Over on Griffin's side of things, the management decided to give all the players a free out. They drafted up new contracts and told the players that they could sign and stay with the team or just leave and suffer no penalties.
Some of the Griffin players could be leaving, some of them immediately as soon as it was announced that if Griffin players wanted to stay, they would, but effectively, they would release them as free agents.
Kanavi was already made a free agent by Riot, but now he was joined by several of his teammates. And after leaving Griffin, Chovy and Doran actually reunited with CVMax on that new Dragon X roster.
Still up here, minute 40. Flash coming in, they really want to get on top of Mystic and just hold it down! And they are going to be able to do enough damage as they knock that Unbreakable out of that Braum, and it looks like Dragon X with that might just be able to win this game.
Of course, Griffin signed new players, a new coach, they made a whole new team. But for most fans, it was no longer the Griffin they fell in love with. The scandal changed everything. On the bright side, Kanavi's contract issues revealed that it was more than just one player getting a raw deal. It exposed the seedy underbelly of an industry that was thought to have long moved past it. There are steps being taken in the right direction. Senator Ha has pushed for an overhaul of the Korean esports contract system. And Griffin? Well, Griffin were once a promising young team that could have been League of Legends' next great dynasty. There isn't much left of that team now, but at least the scandal that destroyed them can help make the future better for everyone.
Thanks for watching. If you want more content like this, hit the sub button and ring that notification bell. For unique bite-sized videos you won't find anywhere else, hit up our Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook pages.